Helm hooks are nothing more than just regular Kubernetes manifests. It can be any Kubernetes object such as a job, pod, config map, secret, etc. The only difference is that Helm hooks are not part of the Helm chart release. For example, you may want to run database migration before you deploy a new version of the application. You can create a Helm hook which will be executed before the Helm application is deployed. In this video, we will create two types of Helm hooks. Pre-install executes after templates are rendered but before any resources are created in Kubernetes. And post-install executes after all resources are loaded into Kubernetes. Alright, first let's create a Helm chart called foo. Now let's create hooks folder under templates. Create first pre-install Helm hook. The first hook annotation equal to pre-install indicates type of the hook. The second hook weight equal to 0. If you have more than one hook, you can define an order to execute them all. The hook delete policy annotation equal to hook succeeded configures lifecycle of that hook. In this case, this Kubernetes object will be removed after successful execution. Next step is to create a second post-install hook that will be executed after application is deployed. The only difference here is a post-install hook annotation. Before we install our chart, let's split the screen and run watch command to keep track of the pods. It will run kubectl get pods every 1 second. Now let's install it. Let's call our release test. You can see that the first pre-install hook will be executed and it will run for 10 seconds. And then it will create the application itself and run the post install hook. Now it's completed, it was removed, and now it's creating the application itself and post install hook that will be run for 10 additional seconds. All right, so the post install hook is completed and the release is deployed. Finally, let's delete our Helm chart. All right. Thank you for watching. Bye.